Welcome to Escape to the Country. The airfield that stretches out behind me played a key role during the Battle of Britain and was also once home to one of Britain's most famous fighter pilots. But who was he and where are we? Well, join me in just a moment and I'll tell you. On today's show, we meet a couple of newlyweds after a home with space and quirks. But one property could be a step too far.
It's unusual. It's not my favourite.
But luckily, we've got more that seems to be a perfect fit.
Wow.
This is very impressive.
This is stylish, sophisticated, just like me.
If you say so yourself. Well, today we are in Cambridgeshire, and this was once RAF Duxford. It is now the Imperial War Museum, Duxford, and houses one of the finest collections of aircraft and militaria in Europe. But during 1940 and the Battle of Britain, the pilots and aircraft that flew from here were tasked with the job of protecting the Midlands, the South East and London from the might of the German Air Force. They were led at that time by Group Captain Douglas Bader, a man credited with having shot down 20 German aircraft. Later on in the show, I'll be back here exploring Duxford's history, its collections and revealing why, for me, it is my favourite museum. Covering some 1,300 square miles, Cambridgeshire lies in the heart of East Anglia and shares seven county boundaries, including Norfolk and Suffolk. Primarily an agricultural county, ancient footpaths and chalk streams crisscross the fields and lead to attractive settlements, the largest of which is Cambridge. Granted city status in 1951, it's world-renowned for the university, impressive alumni and outstanding landmarks, particularly the late Gothic King's College Chapel, founded in 1441 by Henry VI. Away from the city, Grantchester is a place which typifies village life in the county. With picturesque cottages and watering holes, it was once home to war poet Rupert Brooke, and today claims to have the world's highest concentration of Nobel Prize winners. Fine stately homes are also a feature in Cambridgeshire's rural scenery, including the 18th century Wimpole Hall and the 16th century Maddingley Hall. So with this fascinating medley of architecture, countryside and academia, it's no wonder people flock to Cambridgeshire to set up home. Now, when it comes to property prices, the average cost of a detached home here in Cambridgeshire is currently £317,000. That is some 10% above the national figure. And the reason is simple. Cambridgeshire's close proximity to London and excellent transport links into the capital mean that large swathes of this county are now commuter belt. In the south, you will have to pay more than you will in the north. So my advice is to head that way, up towards the Fenland. Your budget will go considerably further. But what about today's buyers? Well, let's meet them and find out why they think Cambridgeshire is for them. When management consultant Zubin and theatre manager Louisa first laid eyes on one another, they soon found they'd each met their match.
I went to join a badminton club because I was trying to get fit, and went along and Zubin was already there. And we just hit it off and became friends, started dating. Things progressed quickly, I moved in.
Next thing we know is she's been around here for the last 2.5 years.
Married for just 6 months, they've decided to leave their current two-bedroom flat in the Big Smoke and start a new country life together.
At the moment, we're living in London. We do have a beautiful flat, but it's very noisy.
There's always a lot of people shouting and screaming. It's Waterloo Station. I live right next door to it, a stone's throw away.
We have trains going past, buses. We've got a bus stop literally just outside the window, so it's very noisy. And it's constant, even at night. We've got the roundabout behind us, which is, it never stops.
Louisa's no stranger to the countryside. She was born in Norfolk and raised in Norwich. But for Zubin, this is a big move. He spent his whole life in a metropolis.
Growing up in Mumbai and living in London is very, very busy. it will be a big change for me. But at the same time, I like when I come home to unwind and relax. I like the ability to kind of sit down and be quiet. It would be nice and relaxing to move somewhere that doesn't have that hustle and bustle around it all the time.
So they've set their sights on a more peaceful pace of life by moving to Cambridgeshire.
Zubin's family's in London, and my family's still in Norfolk, so we were looking for somewhere that was in between both of them. It's also a very beautiful place. I've been a few times and really enjoyed the lifestyle there.
It would be lovely to be able to go see some greenery, go for a little walk where you don't have to be worried about getting run over by an angry cyclist.
They both enjoy hunting for antiques and look forward to discovering more collectibles in the country.
Zubin and I absolutely love going to different sort of markets, finding bits of old jewellery and different types of furniture. It's a great time to spend together, but also to find a treasure or something to bring home and have a story behind it.
The relocation will also involve exploring different pastimes, particularly Zubin's newfound passion for cooking.
We love our food. We do eat out a lot, and I've tried to cook. I've started learning how to cook a lot. Louisa kindly got me some lovely cookbooks to try and follow a recipe. We'd love to have a larger kitchen, and you'd love to have a larger entertaining space.
Whilst this move is about more space and a more tranquil location, it will also mark the beginning of a brand new chapter for our newlyweds.
We're looking to start a family. We want to just have that time to be able to create a home and have a bit more space.
We've done a lot in 3 years, and we're just looking to the future.
Yeah, the next step.
Zubin and Louisa have chosen Cambridgeshire as it's midway between both sets of their parents who live in Norfolk and North London. And they're happy to consider properties anywhere within a reasonable commute of the city. We're all meeting up to find out more about the specifics of their ideal country home.
Well, Louisa Zubin, welcome to Cambridgeshire.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for having us.
Now, Louisa, give us a picture of the kind of property that you've been imagining.
I think we're looking for about 4 bedrooms. We do have friends who live all over the world, so when they do come and stay, it's not overnight. It tends to be for a few weeks at a time. Zubin adores cooking. I don't, so that's a great mix for us. So definitely for Zubin, he would love a big kitchen. Yeah. I think that would be a definite must for you.
Yeah, Louisa would be really nice if she had a nice closet room or a walk-in closet of some sort that she can have handbags and shoes sprawled around and I get some closet space back. That would be really nice. And all something quirky. We both are big
fans
of something quirky.
Character in the building.
And what about outside space?
A little bit of outside space would be really lovely because we don't have that now, being in the heart of the city.
So on the face of it, a nice 4-bedroom family home with a great big farmhouse kitchen, a manageable garden. Is there a catch? Am I missing something?
We'd love a little annex or a room downstairs with an ensuite and maybe a little sitting area for our parents.
So let's talk about the budget then.
The top budget is £800,000, that would be with no work needed at all because we're not very handy with hammer and nails and things like that.
We're in a really interesting county. There's some lovely property here to look at. And you've brought £800,000 for us to play with. How exciting!
Absolutely.
Right then, let's go hunting. Come
on. Let's go.
So with a budget of £800,000, our buyers are looking for a characterful, quirky home that has 4 bedrooms, as well as the potential for a self-contained annex, and a large kitchen diner is a must for Zubin. Thereafter, a modest, manageable garden to suit a family in the future, and the location should be no more than an hour and a half's commute to London. We've got some fantastic houses lined up to present to them, but I won't be revealing the attached price tags until right at the end of each tour. Our final property is the Mystery House, which I think might put to the test their desire for something out of the ordinary. We're kicking off our house tour in the southeast of the county in the village of West Ratting, and the nearest train station to London is just 4 miles away. West Ratting is a picturesque place perched on a ridge that lays claim to being the highest village in Cambridgeshire. In the neighbouring village of Bolsham, there's a local shop and butcher, but in West Ratting itself, there's a popular pub, which is just a short stroll away from our first house.
Now,
oh, wow.
What about this one?
Wow.
Come in.
That's
beautiful.
Amazing.
Yeah. It's pretty, isn't it?
It is beautiful.
Yeah. No one overlooking you as well. I love even the driveway and the little outhouse on the side.
Yeah, you've got a very, very luxurious workshop double garage over there with a studio above it.
Oh wow.
Yeah, but that's the main proposition. Originally, three little cottages brought together with an extension at this end. What do you think, Zibin?
It's very picturesque. It's like out of a postcard.
It was on a village postcard.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Can't wait to go inside.
Let's get in. We've got three doors to choose from. To avoid confusion, they've got a little sign here that says entrance.
It's very helpful.
So we're going to go around the back and into the kitchen.
Brilliant.
With roots in the 17th century, this impressive Grade II listed cottage is packed to the brim with period features. It was sympathetically extended in the 1980s and now offers a flexible layout that could appeal to our couple's need to cater for family and friends.
Oh, nice to get out of the rain. And what a greeting. Look at this.
Oh, wow. It's very much a farmhouse kitchen feel to it, doesn't it?
It is. It's quite nice and homely.
What's curious is that this is the new extension.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the space is great. Big enough, though, I think, for your creative talents in the kitchen. Definitely enough room for pots and pans and
I need a little bit more modernising with some gadgets for me to cook around with. But it's a great space.
But bizarrely with this one, we've also got another kitchen at the far end of the property. So you've got two to choose from. Come this way.
The modern kitchen extension also benefits from a utility room, as well as a boot room, and flows straight into the original part of the house. Passing through a breakfast area that houses the main staircase, you come to the first of two sitting rooms.
Oh, wow. Look at that place.
This is a classic bit of East Anglian 17th century architecture, this great big central chimney stack, which gives you an inglenook on this side and on the other side as well.
It's very different from our flat in London.
Yes. I'll bet it is.
It is like...
This is what I envisage moving to the country would be like, quite picturesque and postcardy. Yeah.
It feels very homely.
Just off this cosy sitting room, a small study fits neatly under a second staircase. Then, continuing further into the cottage, we pass through a large formal dining room before we arrive at the largest of the reception rooms. This adjoins a second kitchen and downstairs bathroom, so it could be utilised as a separate wing or annex.
So this would be the guest end.
This feels lovely. It's a lot lighter than the other two rooms, I suppose, because the ceiling's higher. Oh, and I love this door. Ever so sweet.
It's lovely, isn't it?
You see, that's like a little hobbit door.
It's unusual, this, because it's got two kitchens. If you took this one out, you'd have living room, bedroom, and then downstairs bathroom beyond.
With the potential of a separate wing for visiting parents sorted, it's time to take a look at the main sleeping quarters upstairs. Back along the cottage and up the central staircase, we find a compact shower room and three double bedrooms, all oozing with authentic vintage charm, featuring exposed raw timbers and sloped ceilings. One of these bedrooms has its own separate staircase, accessed from the downstairs dining room. But the room designated as the master lies in the newer wing.
And then finally, this is your bit.
Oh, OK. So this is certainly bigger than the other rooms that we've seen.
Well, this is above the modern kitchen extension. Ensuite round the corner.
OK.
That's
nice. It's definitely got space.
It's got space. Our existing bed might not fit in there.
Really? How big is that? Wow!
Oh, we've got a four poster. That's the problem.
I see the problem. Yeah, the roof may not.
The roof's coming in a bit, but that's fine. We can change the bed. Definitely has potential.
Seeing the possibilities of this property is a positive sign, and I just hope the garden will also deliver on suitability and size. At just over half an acre, it's a lovely, unfussy space, mostly laid to lawn and bordered by box hedges with some mature trees and a large pond.
This obviously is the main family garden. Bags of room for kids to run around in.
I think it's a great space. It's not too big to worry about maintaining it to pristine condition, but it's enough space to, like you say, have kids running around or just enough space to be outside for a bit.
Gives me my outside space and it's a lovely space as well.
Let's have your best estimates as to what this property is on the market for.
I'm going to go 695.
Ooh.
Ooh, yeah, ooh. That's a bit low, I thought.
Ooh, OK.
Oh. I was actually going to go slightly lower than that. I'd say 685.
685? Plays 695.
Not done too well.
Not done well. I can tell by your face.
You haven't done brilliantly, but all is not lost. Okay. This is on the market for offers in excess of £750,000.
Oh, okay. Wow. I think because the inside, potentially, we'd want to look to update it slightly.
Yeah.
That's probably where maybe a bit of our budget would go.
Well, go and have a think about what you'd get for offers over 750, and I will come and find you a little bit later.
Perfect.
Off you go.
£50,000 under budget. This classic historic thatched cottage could give our buyers all the options they're looking for. It has three double bedrooms upstairs, with the potential for a fourth in a separate self-catered wing down on the ground floor. There's also a generous country kitchen alongside a range of reception rooms, and the whole lot lies in a large, easy-to-maintain garden within a popular and pretty village.
The house, it could fit perfectly on a postcard. It's beautiful to look at from outside. The fireplace is absolutely stunning.
The size of the rooms are quite generous. A kitchen is a great size for Zubin to be creative in the kitchen, and I think it has a lot of potential.
Well, that's it. Property number one is done. I think a really good start and an interesting option that I wouldn't dismiss just yet.
Not at all. It's definitely given us food for thought and definitely has potential.
Right, come on, let's go.
Running through the heart of Cambridge is the stretch of the River Cam, now commonly associated with punts. And with Zubin and Louisa keen to explore different activities when they move, we've arranged for them to learn more about the river's history and its punting pioneer. They're meeting customer experience manager, Grace Williams.
Hello.
Hello. Hiya.
How are you?
Good. So tell me a bit about punting.
OK. Leisure punting was first introduced to Cambridge in the very early 19th century by a gentleman called Jack Scudamore. To begin with, the river was predominantly used for cargo because it was a very sort of strong merchant town and the river was a big trade link. And in around the mid-1800s, railways were introduced and it meant that transport by the river was less popular. This gentleman, Jack Scudamore, took the opportunity to purchase these two stations, so here at Mill Lane and at Quayside at the other end, and turned the river into more of a leisure facility than sort of a functional area. So I've arranged for you to go on a tour with one of my colleagues. Oh, and if you'd like to head to the office there,
perfect.
I'll get you on a boat.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
You so much.
Have a good day.
Punts were originally made and used in the shallow waters of the county for catching fowl and fish. Flat-bottomed without a keel, they were crafted from wood and moved using a long pole. Perfect for use on the river, they're now predominantly used for pleasure and make an excellent vessel for a guided tour with assistant station manager Cameron Miller.
It's just past the King's Bridge. Provides us with probably the most famous site in Cambridge, which is King's College Chapel.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It is absolutely stunning.
King's College was founded in 1441 by King Henry VI. The chapel itself was not actually completed until 1536. One of the most famous sites here in Cambridge, besides King's College Chapel, and that is this bridge, the Bridge of Sighs.
Oh, wow.
Bridge of Sighs was built in 1831 by Henry Hutchinson. It's not actually called the Bridge of Sighs, though. Its real name is the New Bridge.
New Bridge.
The Bridge of Sighs is a nickname given to it by a lady called Queen Victoria. She visited the city many, many times. She stated this was her favourite bridge, and it looked just like the original, which is in Venice.
In Venice, yes, the Bridge of Sighs in Venice.
Winding its way past further colleges of repute, the tour comes to an end, and Cameron leaves our couple to make their own way back on the return journey.
Oh, I like this. Let's keep going. Do you need to push off?
It's all right, got it.
Mind your head.
All part and parcel of fun.
And after all that messing about on the river, this is where we leave our buyers until the house hunt gears up in the morning. It's the start of our second day here in Cambridgeshire with newlyweds Zubin and Louisa from central London. Armed with an £800,000 budget, they're looking for character, space and flexibility in a calm rural location, away from the crowds and commotion of the city. Still to come, our much-anticipated and unique mystery house proves that silence is golden.
It is so quiet. Just, you can't hear a thing. It's idyllic. And the space.
And I revisit a favourite old haunt, where I get up close and personal with some military legends.
Here we are surrounded by, you know, a Spitfire and a Lancaster, two of the most iconic aircraft that the RAF have ever flown.
Now, an issue common to many house searches is the need to try and find the space demanded by modern living, yet set within an old and characterful property. Regardless of your budget, it's more an architectural dilemma than it is a financial one. That is certainly, I think, what Zubin and Louisa have found this week so far. So what can we do today, our final day of house hunting, to try and resolve it? Well, we have two more properties to come, including, of course, our mystery house. It is a day of something old and something new, but space is top of the agenda.
We are continuing our Cambridgeshire house search, and our destination is the village of Gamlingay. Once an ancient coaching route from London, Gamlingay was home to many inns, some of which still exist today. In addition, there are also a number of local shops and a primary school. The nearest train station for Zubin is about 4 miles away, with a service to London which takes just over 45 minutes. And right on the edge of the village, we come to our next property.
Well, guys, this is perhaps the most bizarre start to a house tour I've ever done, because you can't really see what I'm about to describe. It's one of 8 brand new conversions on this redevelopment of an old farm complex.
I think we're both intrigued, aren't we?
Both intrigued. We love conversions.
Yeah.
And
it sounds like it might be right for us.
Well, let's see if we're right.
Yeah.
Go on then.
8 barns have been converted in total and have been given Grade 2 listed status as the buildings were originally built in the early 1700s. The one we're showing was completed just 3 months ago and comes with no less than 3 of the dedicated parking spaces within the carport.
Well, this is the obvious place to start, this amazing central hallway.
Wow.
This is very impressive. It's light, it's airy. It's fantastic.
This is me.
It's you, it's very
this
you.
This is brilliant. This is stylish, sophisticated, just like me.
If you say so yourself. I do think it's you. I think it's you two to a T. Come on, let's have a look at the kitchen diner. I mean, this is an enormous space, very echoey because there's nothing in it to absorb the sound. There's the kitchen, brand new. You could have a telly over here with a bit of a sofa as well, the dining table, and of course, you know, access out to the garden through 2 double doors. I mean, it sells itself, this one, really.
It's a lovely space. I can see myself hosting family.
Well, talking about family, because one of the issues we have struggled with is living room space to accommodate these big family gatherings. This, I think, will work. Come and have a look at the living room. There you go.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, that's great. What a fantastic size.
The old beam adds a little bit of character.
Yeah. It really does.
Open 2 doors to look out into the garden.
It's brilliant, you've done well.
Hurrah. Well, we've got 4 bedrooms for you to look at, but let's deal with the main event, the master, that's through here.
So some very encouraging responses to this sleek, contemporary conversion so far. Also down here, there's a separate study, a handy utility room, and finally, a ground floor bedroom suite.
Again, this is a great size room. So this would be the master bedroom.
This is the master bedroom because it's the only one with the ensuite. Have a look in there, that's what it is, over the bath. Again, all brand new, which is rather nice. So I'm thinking that day to day, this is probably you, but when your family come over from India, say, you could relocate upstairs and use the family bathroom for as long as they're here for, and then it's all on one level.
And finally, a bedroom that can hold my 4-poster bed.
Yes, exactly. Exactly, yeah.
I really like it. I really like it. And there's cupboards for all my clothes as well. So, yeah.
It's done really, really well.
Good. Let's see if it keeps going. Come on.
Upstairs, there are three further bedrooms, all of which are large enough to fit double beds. And there's also a fully tiled high-spec bathroom. Heading outside, I'm keen to see what they make of the garden.
Well, at last, you can see it.
Yes, you can.
Because we couldn't when we arrived, of course. You know what's on the inside. That's what it looks like from the outside.
It's lovely. It really, really is lovely.
I'm finding it hard to find a fault in it right now.
Well, the garden is pretty plain, obviously. It's brand new. You've also got this paddock, which you could potentially introduce some apple trees or something, turn into an orchard.
It's lovely, the garden as well. It's the perfect size.
Mm-hmm. So let's think about the price then, Louisa.
I'm going to go £750.
£750, yeah, super.
I think this has ticked off everything we've asked for. I think it would be £815.
So it would be worth it to you for £815,000?
It might just be.
It would be worth it to me if it was £725,000.
Wow.
Wow. That's great.
Yeah. Often people's estimates are a real reflection of how much they want it. And I think you've just given the game away, mate. This clearly works a treat, as I thought it would. Right then, go and have a wander around and I will come and find you a little bit later on.
Fantastic, thank you.
Off you go. Brilliant. Well, that was an easy sell.
Considerably below budget at £725,000, it's been a delight to present our buyers with this Grade 2 listed barn conversion. It has four bedrooms, one of which is a ground floor ensuite with plenty of wardrobe space for Louisa. It also comes, of course, with a large kitchen diner for Zubin and an open level garden, as well as a paddock, all surrounded by wonderful countryside views.
I love this house. It's got everything that we've been looking for. It has the character of an older property, but it has the modern day space that we really are looking for.
It's got a lovely large kitchen and ticked off everything we've asked for.
After you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
One thing I forgot to tell you is that the whole thing comes with a 2-year guarantee as well.
It's not bad at all.
Not bad at all, is it?
It's not too bad at all.
Well, we have one more to see, of course, our mystery house. Will that change your minds, I wonder? Come on.
A little over 70 years ago, the level landscape of Cambridgeshire found itself on the front line of the fight against Germany. One of the county's airfields, RAF Duxford, played a key role in defending Britain in the Second World War, and the actions of its pilots were decisive in helping to win the Battle of Britain. Now a leading aviation museum, Duxford is one of my favourite museums of all time, and I've been coming here since I was 7 years old. For today's visit, information manager Carl Warner is showing me around.
For anybody not familiar with Duxford's history, just give us a quick run through.
The actual historic site goes back to the First World War. It was used in the Second World War, both during the Battle of Britain and, of course, the Great Air Offensive against Germany. And it was even used in the Cold War. So it's got that history running right the way from 1918 all the way through to the 1960s.
Well, let's fast forward to the Second World War in 1940 and when Duxford really comes into its own.
So in 1940, what you would have seen here are squadrons of Hurricanes with Spitfires just down the road at our satellite airfield. And what the pilots were doing was essentially they were responsible for defending the Midlands, but also helping out with the defence of London. So in that great defensive air battle, Duxford's playing its role.
The sense of history here, Carl, is palpable. You can virtually touch it. You can almost taste it. I've always felt that for anybody coming here for the first time, the best place to start is up there in the airspace hangar. Should we go and take another look?
Let's go.
Within the hangar, over 200 aircraft are on display, at least 30 of which tell the story of British and Commonwealth aviation and aircraft development. It also houses some of the most memorable planes to hit the skies, such as Concorde, alongside earlier 20th century examples.
You know, Carl, I never, ever tire of coming in here. There is just so much to see.
What would your favourite be?
I don't know. The Sunderland is an old favourite. You know, I'd love to have travelled the world in one of those. But here we are surrounded by, you know, a Spitfire and a Lancaster, two of the most iconic aircraft that the RAF have ever flown. I mean, I don't know. What's your favourite?
Something else I think is really interesting is the TSR-2.
Well, absolutely, yeah. I mean, there it is. I mean, sadly, an aircraft that never was a commercial success.
It's also one of the rarest. There's only two in existence. But, of course, once we get them, they need to be looked after, they need to be conserved, and that's also what we do here.
The Conservation in Action Hangar is where a team of expert conservators work on preserving the museum's most significant exhibits. I'm heading there next to meet Conservation Assistant Rob Claydon.
Hello, Rob.
Hello, Jules.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you again.
What have you been tinkering with here, Rob?
Yeah, Jules, this is a Pecara, which is from the Falklands War. It was captured back down there in 1982 and is back here. Now, we're just in the process of doing some conservation works.
And as you're taking these aircraft apart, though, I mean, are you getting into the mind of the people who built them? I mean, some of them, you know, 70, 80 years ago.
Very much so. You often think, especially working on equipment or objects from World War II, you think, well, I may be the only person that's ever, you know, touched that since that was built.
So, in a way, you're opening a time capsule, aren't you?
You are.
But your work here at Duxford covers the entire range of the Imperial War Museum's collection, doesn't it? Not just aircraft.
No, we cover tanks, guns, vehicles, anything.
And what's the latest arrival, then?
Ah, well, you'd like to come and see this, Jules.
After you. Well, what have we got here, then?
This is a Husky from Afghan 2012.
And what happened to it?
Well, unfortunately, it hit an IED and completely destroyed the front of the vehicle.
And do we know what happened to the crew?
The crew were safe.
So it did its job?
It did its job.
And I presume this is something you are simply going to conserve and keep it as it is?
Very much so. Kept as it is. In conservation. This shows what war is all about.
It tells the story, doesn't it?
It certainly does.
Fortunately, aviation enthusiasts like Rob, with the dedication and mechanical know-how, are passionately safeguarding these machines along with their legacy as a captivating and poignant reminder for future generations.
Well, guys, from one successful house tour to, I hope, another. Our final property has its work cut out, but it's the mystery house, so anything can happen.
I'm looking forward to it.
Our final property stop takes us north of Cambridge to the village of Holywell, 6 miles from the nearest train station to London. Taking its name from a water well in the local churchyard, the village is full of thick thatched cottages and sits beside the River Ouse. There's a local shop, a primary school, and a pub. Tucked away in the centre, we find our mystery house, which should deliver on Zubin and Louisa's quirky request, but with a modern twist.
Right then, here it is. Our mystery house. What do you think of that?
Wow.
It's very different.
It's very different to anything we've shown you so far this week. It's by far the youngest property we've shown you in many respects. It's a house with a basement, really, but the basement is chock-a-block with rooms, games room. There's a bit of fun to be had with it. What do you think?
It's unusual. It's not my favourite, so I'm intrigued to see what's inside.
This house will have to sell itself from the inside out.
Yes.
And it might, because it's just enormous. Come and have a look.
First impressions for this unusual 1970s mystery house have garnered a rather lukewarm response. As we head inside, I'm optimistic that the layout and generous proportions will change their minds. We're starting off on the top level, where we find a key room for Zubin.
Well, it has space. Which is a good thing.
It's not what I was envisaging.
You're
yeah, it's definitely not what I thought it would be, but I could find myself working in this kitchen, definitely.
What would you change?
I think just to make it a bit more uniform, do you think?
I think I'd make it more uniform, yes. There's a bit of mix and match, but the colour is a little bit brighter than I would like. But
Cosmetic.
Yes, oh, absolutely. There's
nothing major that's not cosmetic.
We change.
What's nice about it, it does sort of flow through to those doors out there, which get you out to a little sort of veranda arrangement. To be honest, even if it had nothing else, this is a great space. But the living area is enormous. Come and look.
Look at all this. Yeah.
Yes, definitely a lot of space.
Wow.
Wood burner there.
Space. Oh, gosh. Oh. That's lovely.
This is a lovely space. And it is so quiet. Just, you can't hear a thing. It's idyllic. And the space.
Yeah,
there's a lot of it.
Definitely have the space, but it feels very snug as well. Right.
Can you see yourself living here?
Starting to. Yeah. Wasn't sure from outside, but now you're inside. It definitely feels very homely, so.
I'd say yes. It's very quirky.
Leaving the kitchen and living rooms behind and heading out into a corridor, this top floor also has a bathroom and four of the property's five bedrooms arranged off the central hallway. The first comes with its own ensuite, next to which is a family bathroom. The second and third bedrooms are both big enough to fit double beds, and at the end is the master.
This is yours, with ensuite and dressing room too there.
And a dressing room.
Mm-hmm. Oh. And look at all that built-in storage.
And all that storage. Well,
somehow I think you've got her attention now.
Yeah, I like the sound of that. Again, it's a nice space room. Feels quite light and airy as well.
There's a bit more to see in the basement.
And what's in the basement?
It's good fun. It's really good fun. Come and have a look.
As I hoped, the upper level of the mystery house has made a great impression on our newlyweds. And there's even more to take in downstairs on the lower ground floor.
There.
It's home from home.
Yeah?
Well, you wondered where you were going to put your pool table.
Well, now we found a spot. We might have to make room for two now, though.
It's great, isn't it?
It's great fun.
To describe this as a basement is to undersell it, really, because you've got not only this area, there's a room through here which they've currently got set up as a music studio. That door goes into what is currently a sort of bookstore come library, could be study, whatever. And then in the corner, another ensuite bedroom. So I'm thinking for your guests, that would work a treat.
Gosh, just didn't expect this.
It's a very deceptive property. It has abundance of space.
This has by far the biggest footprint of our property lineup, at just under 3,000 square feet. Back upstairs and through double doors out to a raised balcony, we arrive at the perfect vantage point to take in the acre of mature garden.
You can see where we started down there with that lovely weeping willow. And you've got a nice mixture of apple trees here.
I like it. I like the space outside. And again, we don't have to do very much to it.
The space up, down, everywhere you look around. There's plenty to see.
Well, let's get down to the numbers then, shall we? Off you go, sir.
I would say this is top end of our budget. 795.
795, yep.
I think it's private, it's secluded. It has a lot of space. I'm going to go on the nose, 800.
You have learnt well this week. It is 795.
Oh!
Sorry. 795.
Wow, on
yeah.
the nose.
Your instincts were okay. Absolutely spot on. I think we should give you plenty of time on this one to wander around, immerse yourself in it, and see if it would actually work. Go on,
brilliant.
Off you go.
Thank you.
We'll find you a little bit later on.
£5,000 under budget, this mystery house has definitely hit the spot. And whilst it may not boast historic character, the modern style and proportions certainly make up for it. Featuring generous living areas, there's lots of storage space for Louisa, plus a large kitchen diner for Zubin. And a whole separate floor could be ideal for a number of visiting friends and relatives, with plenty to entertain them in the form of a games room.
The mystery house was really interesting. It was a right curveball, and it had abundance of space, nooks and crannies that you had to go digging through.
I have to say, when I first saw it, I think I wasn't very enamoured. Having come inside the house, I have changed my mind. I think it's a great space, and it has a lot of potential for us to make into a family home.
Well, I think this is all gone quite well this week.
Thank you very much.
That's all right.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Well, that's it, I'm afraid. The house tours are now over.
Gosh.
Flies by, doesn't it?
It does. There's a lot to think about.
I think there is a lot to think about. Right then, yeah. Off you go.
Thank you.
Let's go think.
Well, I'm satisfied that we have done our job this week, but have our properties done theirs in reassuring Zubin and Louisa that Cambridgeshire is for them? Well, let's go and ask them. Ah, look at this. Relaxing after a busy week.
Absolutely.
Well, guys, it's been good fun, isn't it?
It has. It's been great fun.
It's been fantastic.
And having spent a bit more time out of London, are you still sure that Cambridgeshire is where you want to be?
Yes, definitely. It's lovely to have fresh air, see greenery, and also just to see the properties and the space that they have. It really has been an eye-opener.
Are there any that may be contenders?
I think we've narrowed it down to two.
And which two would they be, Louisa, as if we didn't know?
They're the barn conversion and also the mystery property.
Yes, now then. You can buy only one, despite your £800,000 budget. So which one might it be?
Having talked about it, I think for now, the barn conversion is definitely winning over the mystery property.
The mystery property is probably a project, and the right project, but probably at the wrong time.
But I do think that barn conversion just lit you up like a Christmas tree. I mean, it's such an interesting building. You can make the move without any real stress or hassle and move straight in.
I think that's where we are now with our lives, still commuting to London at the moment. We don't want to be thinking about projects in the future. I think just to move straight in and start living our lives there is what we want. And the barn conversion offers us that.
So what are you going to do next?
We need to view the property again with family.
Yep.
To come and have a look at it. And once they've seen it and we've garnered their opinion, then potentially we'll be putting an offer in.
Might be as early as tomorrow.
Wow! Well, I shall keep my phone on, because if you are able to do it, guys, it would be just terrific to see you make this move.
We can certainly put our mark on it, I think.
Definitely.
So that's a very exciting prospect.
And it's the only one that could host my four-poster bed.
There you go. There you go. Reason enough to want to buy it. Well, guys, it's been an absolute treat, an awful lot of fun. So thank you very much indeed, and best of luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, Cambridgeshire is, of course, an ancient county with a famous seat of learning at its centre. But I think it's fair to say we've all learnt something this week, not least Zubin and Louisa. They still, of course, have much left to discuss and agree upon, but they might do well to bear in mind Cambridgeshire's county motto, with one heart, let us be wise. Now there's some advice. I'll see you next time.
Louisa and Zubin revisited the modern barn conversion a few more times and even put in an offer, but have since decided against it. So their search for their perfect home continues. If you'd like to escape to the country in Northern Ireland, Scotland, Wales or England, and need our help, then please apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.